This is the work-in-progress prototype of my project. I'm building a Raspberry Pi-based MIDI controller and sequencer, and I've decided that I would like to try and document the build process for it. There's two main parts to this project, the hardware and the software. The software will be fully usable without any hardware, but I'm designing it around the hardware interface that I'm building for it. Similarly, while the Raspberry Pi is required to run the hardware interface, it won't be necessary to hook it up to a screen or a keyboard. I intend to eventually turn it into a completely standalone portable music instrument, and it will be possible to hook it up to any MIDI device like a synthesizer, a drum computer, or even a digital audio workstation, and use it as a controller, a sequencer, or an arpeggiator. This video is meant as an overview of what I have made so far. I figured it would be easier to get help and suggestions this way, which is meaningful to me because I don't really know what I'm doing as I have no real prior experience with electronics or big projects. Currently, I have most of the basic functions of the sequencer implemented. There's playing and pausing, patterns, BPM control, and turning individual steps on and off. I have a lot left to implement, and I haven't yet worked out all the details. Some obvious missing features right now are hardware input, MIDI output, and ways to assign note data to a step. I won't go into too much technical detail right now, but here's a quick overview of how it works, as it's not that complicated. If you already have some electronics expertise, this will be pretty self-evident. Basically, up top there's a bank of shift registers, each of which has 8 outputs. Coincidentally, each 7-segment display, contrary to what the name might imply, has 8 inputs. The first 5 shift registers are connected to the 5 displays, and the last 2 are hooked up to the upper and lower banks of LEDs. The program running on the Pi continuously sends a list of bytes that correspond to the correct values, so if the BPM is 120, the first shift register gets sent a byte that visually corresponds to a 1 and outputs it. The second will output a 2 and the third will output a 0. So that's pretty much it. The animations you've been looking at in this video were made mostly as a way for me to experiment with the setup and to figure out how to control it. I think some of them are quite pleasing to look at. For my next video, I'll be expanding the project with no control logic. If you have any suggestions or questions, don't hesitate to let me know. And thanks for watching.